Shocking. Tesla VTOL supersonic jet, are we going to see one anytime soon? In this video, we are going to talk about the Tesla VTOL supersonic jet and are we going to see one anytime soon? Elon Musk has spoken multiple times about his desire to build an electric supersonic aircraft. It was even featured in the Iron Man 2 film, where Elon Musk informs Tony Stark that he has a design for an electric jet. That film was released in 2000. And, most recently, he took to Twitter to reiterate his desire to create such a jet. Thus, how will it operate? And, maybe most importantly, when will we see one? To begin, we must define VTOL. VTOL refers to vertical takeoff and landing, which means the aircraft does not require a runway to take off or land, allowing it to act more like a helicopter in those circumstances. However, the issue with VTOL aircraft is that they often require two types of engines, one for vertical takeoff and landing and another for in-flight power. This is necessary for a couple of reasons. The first is that you would waste a significant amount of energy lifting off, as you would have to direct the engine's power downward to generate lift. This would be a wasteful usage of such engines. Given that supersonic engines function poorly at low speeds, the aircraft's range would be significantly decreased if you chose that path. Now that VTOL has been discussed, it is time to tackle supersonic flight. To qualify as a supersonic aircraft, a plane must exceed the speed of sound. And the speed of sound is not a quantifiable quantity that I can provide you with. Given that most planes fly at a height of approximately 35,000 feet, or roughly half a kilometer, and the temperature at that altitude is typically around minus 56 degrees Celsius, or 217 Kelvin, we may calculate the speed of sound to be 1063 kilometers per hour, or 661 miles per hour. However, flying at Mach 1 is difficult due to the additional drag, which is why modern planes typically cruise at around 900 kilometers per hour, 570 miles per hour. To be supersonic, an aircraft is required to fly faster than Mach 1. For instance, the Concorde flew at approximately Mach 2, which was best for the aircraft's efficiency. Even if the aircraft's speed is increased to Mach 2 or higher, it will have more drag than a subsonic aircraft at the same altitude. Reduced air volume equals decreased weight. Airplanes must fly at an altitude that minimizes drag while maintaining an adequate supply of oxygen for combustion in jet engines. This means that an electric aircraft can theoretically fly higher than a conventional aircraft powered by a combustion engine. Even if no combustion is required to keep the plane airborne, sufficient lift is required to keep it aloft. The only answer is increased speed in order to compensate for the decreased density. This is an area in which Elon Aircraft excels. As you can see, higher altitudes necessitate more speed, but not thrust, because of the low air density. This means that airplanes can fly faster, however, the only thing it needs to do is accelerate the fans, which would be inefficient in a conventional engine. However, this is not the case with an electric motor. Due to the efficiency of electric engines over a wide range of RPMs, they could theoretically spin the aircraft's fans faster. Particularly at the altitude at which it will go. Thus, what altitude will Elon's plane reach? To be honest, it's tough to say, but I'm expecting it'll be similar to the Airbus Silver, which has a range of 65 to 70,000 feet or 20 to 21 kilometers. Additionally, the Airbus Silver is the closest match for Elon Musk's electric supersonic aircraft. Despite the dense air, it revealed the incredible efficiency possible at those altitudes. It did come equipped with solar panels to help extend the range. Nevertheless, it represents a significant step toward future planes. The time has come to face the facts. To propel an electric plane, a power source is required, and that power source is batteries. Their primary disadvantage is their energy density. The Tesla Model 3 and Model Y cars have a battery density of approximately 250 watt-hours per kilogram. To put it into context, jet fuel has a 43-fold energy density advantage over batteries. The reason Elon or anyone else hasn't built a long-haul electric planes yet is unknown, but how long before battery density catches up to flight requirements is unknown. Elon and others have established a standard of 400 watt-hours per kilogram. The difficulty is that battery energy density grows at a rate of 5% every year. According to that projection, these planes will not appear until 2028. Unless battery technology progresses. Fortunately, we have a few potential possibilities. Following that is the SLA, sealed lead-acid, battery. This technology is being used in pacemakers and has the potential to achieve energy densities 2 to 10 times that of conventional batteries. The primary difficulty at the moment is that it evaporates rapidly during recharge, lowering energy density and battery life. Other challenges include manufacturing difficulties, while everyone working on these batteries is aiming to resolve these issues over the next 5 years. Clearly, predicting technical breakthroughs is difficult, but I believe that battery-powered aircrafts have the ability to fly longer distances with less weight and batteries. Jet engines now consume approximately 50% of the fuel they transport. Taking all of this into consideration, the electric plane would have a range of approximately half that of contemporary aircraft. It improves. Due to the fact that drag reduces exponentially with altitude, an electric supersonic jet such as the one Elon hopes to develop could theoretically fly at higher altitudes, reducing drag and so boosting range and speed. The other significant development is expected to be announced next month during Tesla's Battery Investor Day. The game changer is Maxwell Technologies' development of a dry battery electrochemistry. Tesla acquired them in May of last year, and they have remained silent since then. The first advantage to electric engines are, we save money on fuel, which is the airline industry's largest expense. And they would do so if they could eliminate the need for fuel. You must understand that airlines run on razor-thin margins and that a surge in oil prices may bring the industry to a grinding halt, with several carriers filing for bankruptcy. The second advantage is that electric engines would be capable of high speeds, which is critical for airplanes. They are weighing the trade-off between speed and expense. Therefore, if they could reduce their largest operational expense, that would be a win-win for the companies as well as for consumers. Additionally, an electric aircraft requires less maintenance due to the fact that the engines have just one moving part. This saves airlines money, as our planes include millions of components, and a 380 contains 4 million components from 1,500 different manufacturers. Moreover, Tesla is known for its manufacturing prowess, vertical integration, and continual cost-cutting efforts. This might imply a future aircraft with fewer components, less complexity, and thus lower initial and recurring costs. Furthermore, it also eliminates the need for an airport, lowering taxes and replacing wheels and brakes. Finally, and perhaps most significantly, autopilot is a bit of a wild card in terms of regulatory acceptance. It would eliminate the need for pilots, resulting in huge cost savings. The landing is the most dangerous part of the flight. And you're aware of why? Numerous elements must be considered while landing an airplane, including the weather and the landing surface. Vertical flight and landing eliminates this issue. This simplifies and safeguards aircraft landings. Given Tesla's leadership position in fully autonomous vehicle technology and software, I believe they could easily make the VTOL aircraft fly completely independently. As a result, I believe that developing this plane has a lot of promise. Having said that, even if battery technology does not advance tenfold over the next decade, we may soon see short-haul flights powered by a 400 watt-hour per kilogram battery. To be fair, aviation accounts for less than 2% of global CO2 emissions, and Tesla's ultimate goal is to transition the globe to renewable energy. I'm as enthusiastic as everyone else about this jet. However, we may have to wait several years before Elon takes on the task of developing this aircraft, as well as the batteries required for it. However, I'm enthusiastic, and I'll be closely monitoring Tesla in the next months as Battery Investor Day approaches, as well as new products such as the aircraft discussed today. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and leave a comment in the section below and be sure to subscribe for more amazing videos. Thank you for watching.